Hi Ward 3, this is Jasmine Meehan, your city councilor, and I wanted to make a video to explain the budget. You may have read some headlines that the city was looking at the budget, and I want to talk about what it actually means for you. So we've made some really important investments on the basis of all of the things that we just heard on the campaign trail. And I think as much as this is the final year of the city's four-year budget and we will begin another budgeting process coming up, this was a great opportunity for us to come off what we've had just done, a huge public engagement exercise, which is a campaign, and shape what you want to see in the city. So I want to talk about a few things that I heard and how they show up in this budget. The first is I heard over and over again, particularly from our seniors who are on a fixed income, that we need to freeze the user fees on blue, black, and green cards. So that is happening in this budget. The other things that I heard that are very important and are reflected in this budget are traffic safety improvements. I can tell you, after knocking thousands of doors, 15,000 doors, and also being in this job now for a month, that the number one thing we get asked about on the doors and in our email inbox from residents is about traffic safety improvements. So these are things like getting stop signs in new areas, improving crosswalks, and improving the timing of lights, all of those types of things. When we build a city the first time, we don't always understand how people are going to use it. Things change as the population changes, and we need to be able to respond to that. And so this investment is really important to our ward specifically. The second thing is snow clearing. Many of us remember last year we got a huge dump of snow right before the Christmas holidays, and it took a very, very long time for that snow to get cleared. And we do have a smaller snow budget than a lot of other cities, and what I heard over and over from people in the doors is that we want to have better investments in snow, and we need the snow to get cleared faster. And so what this means is that it will reduce the amount of time it takes to clear priority one and two routes, which are in Ward 3. A priority one route would be Country Hills Boulevard or Beddington Trail. A priority two route would be like Hidden Valley Drive or McEwen Drive. And the other thing that this investment does is it has permanent funding for snow clearing on pathways. And this is something, the pathway usage throughout the pandemic was really high. People didn't have a whole lot of places to go. And so being able to go for a walk in your neighborhood on the pathway system and navigate the snow, that's something that's really important from an accessibility and just enjoyment of our community perspective. So I was really happy to see both of those. The other pieces of funding that I would just like to explain why the city is moving on these things and why we're moving on them now. The first one is affordable housing. Now, there's going to be 1,200 Calgarians that are going to get into affordable housing as a result of this investment, and I think that's something that's really important. But the reason this investment needs to happen now as opposed to later is because there is a new federal ministry for housing, and there's also a national housing strategy. And in order to leverage the federal dollars that are coming from the federal government, we need to have shovel-ready projects. And what I heard over and over again at the doors is that, hey, we all pay federal taxes, and we want to leverage that money and ensure that that money actually comes back to our community. And I can tell you that this city council is very dedicated to making that happen. The second thing I want to talk to you about is the climate declaration and some of the funding you see around climate change. Now, I understand that for different folks, this might not be a priority. And I really believe that it is a priority for our city. And I see the private sector often really moving on their commitment to net zero. And I think that the city has to be a true partner in that work. The other thing with this is that we have federally legislated mandates that we're going to have to meet. And in fact, I think those will get tighter over time. And if we think about the city getting to net zero, we are going to have to slowly chip away at that. If we try to, you know, make those targets in one fell swoop, it's going to be a really hard economic crunch. And so with this particular funding, the city is going to be electrifying some of their fleets because it is actually time to upgrade those fleets. And then also some of the retrofitting of buildings will result in the reduction in GHG emissions, but it will also reduce our energy consumption and ultimately our costs in the long term. And the last thing I want to talk to you about is the investment in the downtown. Now, if you didn't hear about it through the campaign cycle, you've probably read about it in other news headlines, is that Calgary's downtown is vacant. And what has happened in Calgary's downtown has frankly been an economic disaster. It's very sad to see what has happened to our downtown. But to give you some sense of the magnitude of the problem is that we have so much office space downtown. We have more office space than anywhere else. And in fact, if you look at just the vacant space that's in Calgary, you could fit the entire downtown of Winnipeg just in our vacant space. That's how much downtown space we have that is for offices. So we need to start converting that into residential if we are essentially going to revitalize our downtown, but also save ourselves economically and from a tax base perspective. Because when we lose the tax base in the downtown, it just gets shifted out to the suburbs. So fixing this problem, even though in Ward 3 we're not in the downtown, it actually really does affect us. And I really think that this investment is very important. So those are some of the big things that came out of this particular budget. I understand that conversations around budget are hard, right? Like, no one ever wants to raise taxes. And this is going to be an additional $6.20 a month on tax bills. But I want you to understand that I genuinely believe that that is a smart investment, and that if we don't spend that $6.20 now, it could be $15 down the road, right? Because there are money that's just going to have to be spent down the road to keep up with population and inflation. And to put in perspective, with this particular adjustment, we are still not keeping up with the city's population growth and the inflation constraints. So I really am happy to take any questions on the budget. I know we're not always going to agree on what we should be spending on, but my commitment to everyone throughout the campaign and will always be that I will be accountable to you. I will explain why I made the decision that I made, because that's the biggest thing I also heard, is that people want to be part of this process. They want to understand why decisions are being made. And I think, you know, when we make tough decisions as legislators, it's incumbent on us to actually come on and explain why we made these decisions so that you understand it and can respect it, even if maybe you don't agree with it. So if you have any questions, you're always welcome to reach out to my ward office. It's ward03@calgary.ca. Looking forward to hearing from you. Have a great weekend.